Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Jan, and I love making fantasy maps. And today we're going to start a series about making a fantasy world map in Incarnate. The version of Incarnate that I'm using is Early Access version 1.0. You can apply for Early Access if you are a pro subscriber to Incarnate. Information about it is on Reddit, but version 1.0 will also come out somewhere in 2020. So you can also just wait till this one comes out. And maybe it has already come out when you're watching this video. I'm just going to switch my screen. There we go. Yeah, it's going to be a series about creating a fantasy world map. So a big fantasy world. But before we get started, I want to show you a little bit about what I'm doing. I make fantasy art. And I love making fantasy maps. But the thing that I'm doing most of my time is creating top-down fantasy tokens. You can kind of imagine these being like digital version of minis when you're using a program like Roll20 to simulate a virtual tabletop and you want to use your minis on a battle map. You can use my my tokens for a as minis, and I also make fantasy maps, and sometimes I show them on my Patreon. My Patreon is called Online Tabletop. You can find my stuff on DriveThruRPG and Roll20, of course. So let me close these guys off and we're gonna get started with creating a fantasy map in Incarnate. Create your first map. We're gonna go for a fantasy world. So we're gonna choose the style and I'm gonna print it out probably on A3 or A2 size. So I want the aspect ratio to be A4 landscape, and I'm going to be editing in ultra 4K resolution. I could also edit in 2K, I guess. Let's do 2K. I usually do 4K, but I just want to see if it actually changes. I don't think, because I don't have a 4K monitor. So we're going to try that out. One thing that I want to do is I'm going to press save. Early access is not 100% stable yet, so I will save quite often. I'm going to call it Jan's Fantasy World Map 1. And what I want to do is export. Just wait till it saves. And I want to export as image. I'm not going to do HD, I'm just going to do normal. I'm going to show in folder, and I'm going to open this up in Photoshop. What I want to do is I want to create a background texture that is my and let me open one tab real quick. A background texture that I made in Photoshop. So what I will do is I will copy this landmass that I've created in Photoshop before, and I'm going to paste it in here. I'm going to scale it to the right size. And then I'm going to merge down, press Ctrl S to save. And that will be my background image. You might think, what are you doing? Well, I kind of like the randomness that the Photoshop clouds give. And I kind of like the fact that I can drag around my landmasses in Photoshop. So I feel Photoshop is still easier to create like a base of my landmass. If you want to learn how to do that, I've got a YouTube tutorial about that. Let me find the tutorial real quick. My channel. There we go. All right. Let me just skip this ad. And then I can show it to you. There we go. So I made a video called Fantasy World Map, Creating Interesting Shapes in Photoshop. And here you can learn how to create cool thumbnails and shape ideas for your maps in Photoshop. So once I've done that, I will go back to my Incarnate. I'm going to go to my brush tool. I'm going to choose a texture and I'm going to upload my own texture. And I will upload the file that I created, and I'm gonna go for, you can select the times the scale is repeated, so I'm gonna go till it fills, so 2 times, save texture. That's okay. And now it should be in here. I'm gonna go to the background, take a big brush with no softness, and I'm gonna draw in my world as a background texture. There we go. And now we're gonna block out our land masses, and we're gonna do that with the mask tool, and we're gonna make use of roughness. So I'm gonna start with a roughness of, let's say, 6. Then I'm gonna fine tune it later. Down tune the scale a little bit. And for this, I will zoom in. And I'm just gonna block in these land masses using Incarnate. And the new roughness brush that Incarnate has is pretty, pretty epic. I'm really happy with that. I'm not thinking too much about this, just kind of tracing the edges of the landmass, and then I will fill the landmass in. There we go. This one. So I'm switching between adding and subtracting by pressing A and D, and you can see it in the top here with the plus and the minus. If I press D, I'm gonna remove a little bit. If I press A, I add, and these shortcuts make it much easier to create a cool landmass. All right. And again, make sure we save often, just because it's not 100% stable yet. If you're using early access, you want to save often. I'm quite sure if by the time you're watching this, 1.0 officially has come out, it will be much more stable. Create some landmass here, some blob here, and then we go to the big landmass. Yeah, let me tell you something about what I'm thinking of using this map for. So currently I'm working on a pirate campaign. It's going to be fantasy. There's going to be orcs, elves, and so on and so on. It's not going to be like 100% Caribbean pirates style with no or low fantasy, but it's going to be medium fantasy. And what I mean with that is, in the old world, magic is quite rare, maybe kind of like Lord of the Rings. And then when the new world is discovered, all these ancient temples are found and basically magic reawakens. So this is something that I'll keep in mind, and maybe I can do something with it while making a map. But just having this background story before thinking about making a map adds some immersion and some commitment to your shapes and so on. Things make more sense if you do that. One of the things that I will have to think about geographically is I want to have like sort of like a Caribbean. So if this is the old world and people set sail from here and go to the new world, there need to be a bunch of islands in around the equator to have kind of this the tropical pressing the wrong button, the tropical feel. And also in the old world, I want to have an area that is mostly inhabited by humans, elves, dwarves, and halflings. And then there's a big mountain range, and beyond that is like a bit of wildlands where a lot of orcs and goblins live, deserts and steppes and things like that. And there's where a lot of the slaves come from. The orcs are taken as slaves because they're very good for hard labor. They don't complain that much when they have to do physical work. So there's slavery. It's going to be like sort of like not really gothic, but it's going to be a bit dark and a bit gritty. So I'm just filling up these land masses. There we go. And the last one. And I really like the new features. Have I said it before? I like the new features of Incarnate 1.0, especially the roughness. Things are just much more smooth now. They really listened to the critiques. We can actually use undo now, which I'm really happy about. They didn't have it before. So this will be the base of our map. Save. Next thing I want to do is I want to start tweaking the map with fine roughness. So I'm going to go to 3. And one thing I want to do is I want to kind of have an idea of where my continental plates will be. And I will use the path tool for that. So one thing that I know is that my old world has like a big mountain range that separates my old world from more like to Europe and then more steppes and deserts in the other side. So my mountain range is going to be somewhere around here. That's where some colliding continental plates will be. So the land masses will merge, like bounce together, the plates will bounce together, creating a big mountain range. By the way, when I'm creating these plates, continental plates, I want to tell you I didn't study geology. I'm quite interested in geology. So if this is not 100% accurate what I'm doing, please correct me in the comments, but also keep in mind that I'm like not 100% knowledgeable about how all of this stuff works, but I think the amount that I do know really adds some realism, or at least belief, not realism, but believability to when I make the fantasy maps. So try to keep that in mind. So big mountain range there. Let's have a big mountain range on this coast, like this. Maybe something like this. So these are all colliding plates. And now I want to have some diverting plates. So let's have like a mid-ocean mid-ocean trench. It's too straight. About here. Oh, this one should be red. Let's have a diverting area here. Not too horizontal. Let's go like this. This might be cool. Let's have one here. Let's make one here. Maybe one here. And for now, this will be enough information to tweak our land masses a little. So I'll tell you what I will do with this information. It might look like just some random lights at the moment, but I'll explain to you. So where the land masses come together, where they are colliding, there will come some mountains to exist. So these lands will come together here, and also some islands will come to exist, some volcanic islands. Let's just make it like this real quick. I want to make it a little bit smaller. And then maybe something like this. Yeah. So that already looks kind of interesting. And then over here, you have something similar going on. So this is basically an extension of the mountains, but they're underwater and only the peaks will come out. That works. Let's find this area and do the same. And again here as well. I don't know why I always make three. Let's remove it. Looks like I'm always making the exact same pointy, and I don't want that. All right, that looks good. And we'll do the same here. And here. And I kind of like that this roughness adds this randomness. All right, that looks cool. Maybe remove this one. No. All right, and then we go check out these diverting lines. Where these diverting lines come to exist? So imagine yourself, there's this lava, these continental plates are drifting apart. This lava is getting spewn out, and sometimes this lava cools down, gets spewn out again, cools down, and creating these volcanic islands. And these islands are highly unstable. There's a lot of volcanic activity in these islands. And sometimes the bottom part of the earth crust, the top part will drift around while the bottom part will kind of stay in the same place. And then the hot spot where the lava is spewn out gets dragged a little bit. And because the earth is spinning a certain direction, you kind of get these crescent shaped island patterns. Yeah, so I think they are quite interesting as well. So maybe this is some like Hawaii or Southeastern Asian islands like that. And I do like them, although I wish I could grab them and move them a little bit to here. But you can't do that in Incarnate. So I'm just gonna try and copy them a little bit. I like the other ones better, but it will have to do. Right, let's remove these. Not 100% happy about these islands. I don't know, just the shape is something that I'm unhappy with. Sometimes happens. Needs to look organic. That's better. All right, let's press save. And we're gonna go to some more of these diverting areas to create some random islands. leave it. We can make some here, but I'll explain later why they might be a bit different than the other islands that we're making. It's because they're very north, and in the north, other things happen. You might know what, like in the extreme north and south. Alright, this is enough of those. Alright, let's save. And then I'm gonna add some islands around the landmass, just to show where some islands might have eroded in. Some of the softer soil might have been pushed away, and some of the harder soil might have stayed, creating these islands at the sides. And especially around my Caribbean. Just because I need it for the lore of the map, I need to have a lot of islands. And there's going to be a lot of small islands, which are so small that you can't really see them on the world map scale as well. So you don't have to draw in every tiny island. Keep that in mind as well. Just adding some islands here and there. And tweaking the edges where I feel like it's too straight. I'm just gonna tweak it by removing some with my mask tool. All right, this looks cool. I might even have too many of those islands already, but we'll see. Alright, I like where it's going. I'm gonna save. Oh, this is not save, this is a node tool. next thing that I wanna do is I wanna talk about fjords. So, if I understand correctly, fjords come to exist because of glaciers. So, if I understand correctly, and if I don't, please correct me in the comments, the glaciers push the soft soil, or the glaciers are filled with all kinds of sediment, rocks and things like that, and it pushes and compresses some of the soil that it pushes along. So when there's an ice age and these glaciers expand, they will push a lot of this landmass inwards, creating fjords. So they happen at the coldest parts, the north and the south poles, and they just push a lot of these sediments in, creating these fjords. So let's make some fjords around the north and the south. See how that looks. Yeah, that looks pretty cool. put to this side. I think this point can get removed. You don't have to stick with something you planned from the start if it doesn't feel right. Sometimes I just take something and make a pretty drastic change. Let's see, maybe one here. The rest is too low to have some fjords. All right, that looks cool. And let's go to the lower parts as well, especially this one. And maybe one or two here. Looks good. All right, save. All right, next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to paint in my background ocean color, just because I want to get rid of this this gray that I have. So I'm going to go to my brush tool and I'm going to find, I think the original color that it uses is water blue green 0.2 or 0.3. Let me check. 1 second. Map real quick, and I want to see what the original ocean color is, just to check. All right, water green 03. Yeah, that's it. It's 03 water green. 02 is too dark. Yeah, so it's water green 03. Let's find it. We brush it in. All right, starts to look good. Save. Next thing that I want to do is I want to place some placeholder mountains, just so I can get rid of my my plate lines, because they're not so pretty. So I'm going to go to the stamp tool. I'm going to go to scale it down a little bit, maybe like 50. Let's go to 50. And I'm going to start to place some mountains. These will just be temporary mountains. I'm going to add some other mountains later on. But the nice thing about Incarnate is that when you feel like you did too much stylization and you need to change it, you don't have to go like, "Oh, I did all this work," because there's already all this pre-made really cool artwork that you don't have to worry about. You can just place it back in with a few clicks. Looks too evenly distributed, so I'm gonna grab a couple of those. All right, add some mountains here. Oh. You can push the bracket keys to choose a mountain that you like from the list. Like this, make some mountains here. And make some mountains over here. So we can have some bigger ones in the middle. And then we're gonna go a little bit smaller. and even smaller. Looks good. Maybe place one or two in here. Yep. All right. I'm quite happy with that. Maybe like some older mountains that were already pushed around in when the world was like more like a Pangaea. We can have some separate mountains maybe. Just where I feel they might fit. Something like that looks good. All right, next thing I want to do is I'm going to my select tool and I'm gonna declick all and I just want to select the parts and then I'm gonna press Ctrl A to select all and press delete to get what we want. All right, I'm gonna press save. And this is where I'll stop for today's episode. So next episode, we're gonna work on some of the colors. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you liked it, please, of course, press a like, leave a comment. I really love reading your guys' comments. If you really, 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 really liked it, press subscribe and the bell icon, and you will get a notification when I post a new video. All right, thank you very much and see you next time. Bye-bye.